San Miguel Corporation planning to operate a bus rapid transit system or a high-capacity point-to-point bus system on its Skyway toll road system. That news was shared by none other than the company's president and COO, Ramon Ang. In a Facebook post, Ang said the bus system would initially operate between Susana Heights in Muntinlupa City and Balintawak in Quezon City. Calling it a game changer, Ang said a bus-based transit system will make commutes faster and help ease traffic on public roads. San Miguel recently opened its Skyway Stage 3 project, which connects the North and South Luzon Expressway. That has cut travel time between both thoroughfares down to just 20 minutes. The Duterte administration sticks to some of its economic targets despite the expected impact of tighter quarantine measures and the recent spike in COVID-19 cases. At least one analyst says the government is turning a blind eye to the real situation. Warren de Guzman reports.
The Duterte administration's economic team held a pre-sauna event Monday to seek additional recommendations from the private sector through the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry on how to move forward with the remaining year or so of President Rodrigo Duterte. The economic team also delivered an update on the economy, and they say for now, they are keeping their economic assumptions for 2021, which were set before the current COVID-19 spike and return to tighter quarantine conditions.
We have a target of 6.5 to 7.5% this year. And we are still early in the year, I think, to make changes. We have not yet seen the impact of the ECQ and our quarantine on the first quarter. So I would wait for more data. What we have seen so far is prior to the spike, we have a significant improvement. We have also recovered fully all the jobs lost from the ECQ last year. In excess of 600,000.
Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno gave a personal assessment on the matter, saying the reimposition of ECQ and MECQ might have reduced growth by as much as 0.5%, but he also says he stands by the NEDA forecast. Budget Secretary Wendell Avisado says the Development Budget Coordination Committee will be meeting soon, possibly next month, to revisit the macroeconomic assumptions and consider the implications of the return to ECQ, as well as the surge in COVID-19 cases. Meanwhile, Secretary Chua also revealed the government is maintaining its poverty incidence target of 14% or lower for 2022 as part of President Duterte's 10-point socioeconomic agenda. This elicited a strong reaction from data scientist and UP professor Peter Caiton, who says in his opinion, the economic team is turning a blind eye to the impact of COVID-19 on poverty. Participants at the Sulong Pilipinas event also asked some hard questions, including Dipolog Chamber of Commerce and Industry President Rolando Soliva, who said the aggressive central bank monetary policy easing, including successive cuts to key interest rates, are not being felt by all. He says private banks have actually raised lending rates. Central bank data show that instead of lending more, banks have actually tightened their credit standards, making it more difficult for businesses and consumers to borrow due to concerns over the impact of the pandemic on the public's ability to pay back debt. Jokno, however, says the measures will remain until improvements are seen in economic growth and employment, as long as inflation remains in check.
We recognize that the economy is still in its nascent recovery phase. The accommodative monetary policy settings provide significant stimulus to demand and should be allowed to continue to work their way through the economy to boost recovery in private consumption and investment.
Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez also reveals there are ongoing talks for possible additional stimulus.
Right now, we are in discussions with the leadership in Congress regarding Bayanihan 3. We are exploring additional sources of revenue to mitigate the impact of an expenditure program on our fiscal deficit. The other avenue are exploring is the possibility of cutting down non-essential government expenditures. So we are looking at that too. The third area we are looking at is increasing the dividend rate of the GOCCs from 50% to 75%.
Aside from that, and waiting for the COVID-19 vaccination program to accelerate, Dominguez says the economic team will be busy with the Build, Build, Build infrastructure initiative and the remaining tax reform measures pending in Congress as part of efforts to restore the Philippine economy to pre-pandemic levels. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.